Bacterial meningitis. The most common causative organisms of community-acquired bacterial meningitis are Streptococcus pneumoniae and Neisseria meningitidis. Predisposing and associated conditions help predict the meningeal pathogen. In the patient with pneumonia, Streptococcus pneumoniae is a likely meningeal pathogen. When meningitis is suspected in a patient with a recent history of otitis, sinusitis, or mastoiditis, the etiologic organisms are Streptococci species including Streptococcus pneumoniae, gram-negative anaerobes including Staphylococcus aureus, Haemophilus species, or Enterobacteria. The most common causative organisms of bacterial meningitis in the patient who has had a neurosurgical procedure are Staphylococci, gram-negative bacilli, and anaerobes. It is important to recognize when an anaerobe may be the meningeal pathogen, as that possibility necessitates the addition of metronidazole to the empiric regimen. Also include Listeria monocytogenes as a possible meningeal pathogen in patients who are pregnant, adults over the age of 55, and individuals with impaired cell-mediated immunity due to chronic illness, organ transplantation, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, malignancy, or immunosuppressive therapy. The clinical presentation of bacterial meningitis was recognized as the classic triad of fever, headache, and stiff neck. The patient also can present with an altered level of consciousness. Every patient suspected of bacterial meningitis should be checked for CBC, blood cultures, a C-reactive protein, and a serum procalcitonin. A normal C-reactive protein has a high negative predictive value in the diagnosis of bacterial meningitis. An elevated serum procalcitonin concentration occurs in severe bacterial infections. The serum procalcitonin is an additional helpful test in differentiating bacterial meningitis from viral meningitis when the CSF gram stain is negative. Head CT with contrast also recommended evaluating a leptomeningeal enhancement. The gold standard for the diagnosis of bacterial meningitis is, of course, analysis of the CSF. The CSF usually obtained by lumbar puncture procedure or by surgery if the patient undergoes ventricular peritoneal shunt or extraventricular drainage. The management of bacterial meningitis includes the eradication of the meningeal pathogen with antimicrobial therapy as well as the prevention, as much as possible, and treatment of the acute complications of this infection. The acute complications of bacterial meningitis are increased intracranial pressure, cerebral edema, coma, ischemic and hemorrhagic cerebrovascular disease, venous sinus thrombosis, cranial nerve palsies, and vestibulocochlear involvement. Empiric antimicrobial therapy is modified once the meningeal pathogen has been identified and the results of antimicrobial sensitivity testing are available. Unfortunately, it is both the multiplication of the bacterial organisms and the lysis of bacteria by bactericidal antibiotics with the release of bacterial cell wall components that initiates the cascade that leads to neurologic complications. The release of bacterial cell wall components induces the monocytes, macrophages, brain astrocytes, and microglial cells, also called CNS macrophage equivalent cells, to produce the inflammatory cytokines and chemokines. The inflammatory cytokines are the endogenous host mediators of inflammation and are directly responsible for altered blood-brain barrier permeability, decreased cerebral blood flow, the purulent exudate in the subarachnoid space, and the production of excitatory amino acids and reactive oxygen and nitrogen species. The interest in dexamethasone therapy has grown to prevent inflammatory cytokines from being released. Dexamethasone inhibits the synthesis of the inflammatory cytokines, reduced meningeal inflammation, decreased cerebral edema and intracranial pressure, and stabilized the blood-brain barrier, which decreasing vasogenic edema, the leakage of serum proteins, and the formation of the purulent exudate in the subarachnoid space. Therefore, dexamethasone should be started prior to or with the first dose of antibiotic therapy. The recommended dose of dexamethasone is 10 mg every 6 hours for 2 to 4 days. In the conclusion of therapy, all patients suspected of bacterial meningitis should be started with an empirical antibiotic regimen, ceftriaxone 2 grams every 12 hours, or cefotaxime 2 grams every 6 hours, and dexamethasone 10 milligrams every 6 hours given with or after antibiotic administration to prevent cytokine release. If the patient is allergic to ceftriaxone or cefotaxime, chloramphenicol 25 milligrams per kilogram every 6 hours should be initiated. If the patient is 60 years old or older, add amoxicillin or ampicillin 2 grams every 4 hours along with ceftriaxone and dexamethasone. Dexamethasone should be stopped in 2 to 4 days even if the patient deteriorated. If the infection is considered by the resistant pneumococcal, vancomycin 15 to 20 milligrams per kilogram every 12 hours or rifampicin 600 milligrams every 12 hours should be added in the regimens. The antibiotics then should be switched to based on the pathogen detected in the blood culture. Antibiotics should be given at least 10 to 14 days. If you find this video helpful, please hit the subscribe and bell buttons. And don't forget to like and share this video. Thanks.